In a previous video, we looked at taking that important first step of upgrading your eyepieces and setting you on the road to getting better views with your telescope, your basic telescope. In this video, we're going to take a look at some of the detail of different eyepiece designs in a bit more detail. Again, pretty much with the idea of you upgrading and getting better views out of your telescope. In the previous video, we looked at upgrading basic modified achromat eyepieces with good quality plossels, pointing out that the plossel gave a better field of view. The optics were probably going to be delivering much sharper views owing to the improved contrast that you could expect to get out of the plossel. The better design all round, the improved anti-reflection coatings that you tend to get on these eyepieces, and just the fact that the actual glassware in the eyepiece is physically better because you've got four lenses in there. Let's just point out a few other things, eyepieces that you could use to expand the power of your telescope. These are becoming increasingly popular. This is a zoom eyepiece, and instead of just being one fixed focal length, this is offering you a range of focal lengths from 7mm here all the way up to 21. There are a number of different models on the market. You can visit our websites and take a look at the eyepieces there and see a couple of these zoom eyepieces. They're very versatile. Instead of carrying around a whole gadget bag of eyepieces, you end up with just one. Important to remember, really, with the zoom eyepiece, that there is an element of compromise. Not too surprisingly, I think, that the eyepiece at all these different focal lengths probably won't perform anything like as well as a fixed focal length plossel eyepiece. And I don't think that's any surprise to you. I don't think a Swiss Army knife is really going to work as well as an individual saw or an individual screwdriver, so that's no surprise. What is a bit of a surprise, though, is that you'll actually find that at the short end of the focal length range here, the 9 to 7 mil, they really do perform very well, and you've actually got a very good field of view. So the whole thing isn't just a compromise. You've actually got one part of the zoom ring there that's actually quite spectacular. Anyway, that's a fairly cost-effective way of upgrading your eyepiece range. Just very briefly discuss focal lengths here on the eyepiece. These numbers that you'll see giving you the detail of the specification of the eyepiece, it's important to understand that that is not a direct relationship to the magnification of the eyepiece. This is actually referring to its focal length. So very much like the telescope has got a focal length that you can measure, the eyepiece as well as a focal length. And hopefully by now, you've probably picked up one of the most important details, that the smaller this number on here in millimeters, the more powerful that eyepiece is likely to be with any given telescope. There's no fixed relationship between the eyepiece and any given telescope. It's entirely dependent on the focal length of the instrument you're using it with. So this eyepiece can be used with both these telescopes, but because they're very different focal lengths, the main instrument, they're going to actually deliver different magnifications. Now, magnification is one of those things that's always important when you're using a telescope, because you want to be able to see detail in the target. And in a previous video, we've actually dealt with Barlow lenses, so I'm not going to say too much about that. But a Barlow lens is a great way of giving yourself extra eyepieces. You may have got a Barlow lens with your telescope, but just like the eyepieces, it almost certainly deserves to be upgraded. The one I'm showing you here is a three-element Barlow. The important thing to get about the Barlow lens is it's basically an amplifying system. This is used with the telescope and has an amplifying effect on the primary focal length of the telescope. Now, of course, if it increases the focal length of the telescope, when you insert an eyepiece into the Barlow, it obviously has a multiplying effect on the magnification of that particular eyepiece. So if your telescope has 1,000mm focal length and 2,000 when you use it with the Barlow, then of course the magnification of the eyepiece when it's used with that telescope is going to be doubled along with it. There are different focal lengths. I'd advise you to stay with the 2x when you're first upgrading your telescope and actually have a look at a good Barlow. If you've only got a very basic eyepiece collection, then you're quite likely to want to expand it, obviously, and upgrade the eyepieces and add to your collection slightly so that you've got range of eyepieces that I was talking about earlier. Definitely give some consideration to Kellners. Now, I spoke somewhat disparagingly of the modified achromat in an earlier video, and also the Huygens type eyepieces with their limited number of elements. So that may have given you the impression that few elements is always a bad thing. Well, not necessarily. If the elements have been weighed well enough, you could actually find that an element, an eyepiece with the minimum number of elements may actually give a very bright view. And if the optics have been crafted carefully enough, that may also give you a very sharp view as well. Now, a case in point here are good quality Kellner eyepieces. Now, these seem a little bit old-fashioned by today's standards. We've got used to modern PLOSL eyepieces having a nice soft rubber eye cup and a certain kind of look to it. Kellner eyepieces typically are in a hard all-metal body like this, rather than having the sexy rubber eye cup of the PLOSL eyepiece. But don't look askance at the Kellner. These can be absolutely great eyepieces for planetary viewing. They take a little bit of getting used to, especially if you wear eyewear, because of that flat surface on it. They're a little like orthoscopic eyepieces in that regard. In fact, the orthoscopic eyepiece has got a very similar performance profile to a good Kellner. You tend to hear orthoscopics being talked about on forums because they are often a weapon of choice for the planetary observer. But the Kellner a really good quality Kellner can be the equal of an orthoscopic, but probably a third of the price. Bear in mind, some of these Kellners can be bought for change out of £20 from the Astronomy and Nature Centre. So that can be a low-cost way of improving your high-powered viewing. Probably wouldn't bother with the ones that are a longer focal length than 10 millimetres. They often come in focal lengths ranging from 5 to 10 mil. Any of those are probably worth a punt if you're interested in getting very high-quality views of planetary targets. Anyway, this was just a short video just to give you a little bit of information about other eyepiece types that you could use to enlarge your eyepiece connection. Bye for now.